Speaking of cartoonists, your paths did cross with Bill Mauldin.
Yeah, Bill Mauldin came in when we got into Naples, Italy. And we were, so I was 1 year in North Africa, in Algiers, and then the invasion of Italy, Sicily, and then Italy. I mentioned in my book, it was so strange that his first drawings that he did for Stars and Stripes was very anemic, very weak. And I called him over to teach him how to do a gutsy brush line. I see this is wartime, you know, and you got to have a good strong line trick. So I demonstrated to him, and he just watched me work for about a half an hour, and he never said a word, never said thank you. He walked away. He changed overnight, and he started working in that technique he used all through the war. And he never changed for that from that technique for the rest of his life, and kind of. A little annoyed me a little bit that he never even said thank you, you know, because I changed his whole life for the. But he wasn't drawing. You don't know how to delineate a man who's been at the front for a month or so, and he's so bedraggled and ragged, and no, I'll say ragged, but the clothes on his pants are all wrinkled, and you know how to get those folds into the pants. It's a way of drawing it anyway, how to delineate it. And so she copied my technique, and then. But shortly after, well, a few weeks later, somebody said, "Oh, your work looks like Mauldin's." I thought, "Oh my God, you know, here I had to change my technique because he was getting all the notoriety, and I was not getting the notices he was." But we were good friends, and we had a two-man studio all through the war, and we kept it up right to the end, you know.
Did he have the characters then? Was it
his characters?
Yeah.
Well, he made them up, and I ended up being Willie and Joe a few times, not too often. Occasionally, Ed, would you hold a pose, you know, and I would pose for him, you know, for Willie and Joe, you know. And we were good friends. We double dated, you know, and well, we're in Italy. There was two young signorinas, you know, and they were cousins. And I remember going out on the beach with them in the northern part of Italy, of Naples, rather. Of course, we went with the chaperones, you know. The chaperones stood always close by, or rather sat close by us, you know, make sure there's no hanky-panky, you know. Bill was a good boy, though. He kept his nose pretty clean, except for one little instance which I wrote in my book, contract for writing up front, you know. Mm-hmm. And that's a funny story, because he told me he got an advance on the royalties of $5,000, and to celebrate, he took a young lady up to his room, and his room was next to me to my room. This was in Grenoble, and he took this very pretty young girl up to his room, and he shut the door, and my room was next to him. His room, rather, and he could hear the typewriter clacking and clacking. Then all of a sudden, he hear the bed springs going, squeaking. Then the clacking of the typewriter again, and then back it went on for a whole week. And they never came out. We shoved the food under his door, and he stayed there for a whole week. He wrote up front and with this young lady. And so that's a story of how up front was written.
No kidding.
Yeah.